Yes, record start.
So, well, the second unit of the subject CP5151 is dealing with the hierarchical data structure. So, the word hierarchy comes in the data structure, immediately you should focus on parent-child relationship structure, which is nothing but a tree. So tree data structure. So what is this tree data structure is? It is a non-linear data structure. Of course, when you want to store the data is not stored in a continuous locations or contiguous location. It is stored in some manner that is always treated as a manner that is against linear, that is a non-linear manner. So when you look at the logical diagram of the tree data structure, you may see a lot of circles and lines. The circles are named as nodes and the lines are named as edges. So it is a collection of nodes and edges. And this particular structure, as it says that, it represents the hierarchical relationship. That is, the node that is situated at the top will be treated as the parent. Others are treated as the descendant child. So there is parent-child relationship that is called in general hierarchy. So you may not say that it is exactly a parent, it may be organization hierarchy also, that is manager, assistant manager, cashier, accountant, like that you can go, or dean, head of the department, faculty, student. So that may be some level of organization. So layer one, layer two, layer three, like that level of organization. So that is called hierarchical data structure. That is, if you want to organize the data, that is the data which is very big in the sense with respect to value or most important with respect to the priority. So you will be occupy the topmost position, followed by the next least priority, next least priority, like that. So that is called hierarchy. So that is the idea in which you need to study about a data structure called a tree data structure. So when you are going to study a new topic, that is a tree data structure, like this kind of topic, you always encounter some special kind of terminologies like root node, parent node, child node, leaf node, degree, level, height, depth. Still many things are there. So remember, students, when MCQ type questions would be asked, they will be giving you a tree like this, and you will be asking us identify the parent node of C. What is the parent node of C? It is A. Identify the degree of the given tree. What is the degree of the given tree? Say the degree is how many maximum number of edges arising out of a node. So how many edges are arising out of a node? Two edges. So it is two. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. So the nodes are arranged at different levels. That is called level. So it is root node is at level zero. So when you want to number the level, see there are how many levels in the tree? One, A is at A node level one, level B, C level two, D, F, G level three. And I say, let me take a marker. This is level one, this is level two, level three, level four, level five. That is, there are so many five levels are there. And if you want to number the level, root node is at level zero, this is one, this is two, this is three, this is four. Like that, you have to number. That is the level. So leaf node, the node which doesn't have any children, that is H, I, K, L, M, these are the nodes, E, G, these are child node. Parent node, the node that gives rise to some other child, that is called parent node. Root node, that is the parent of all the parents. That is a node that is situated at the very top node, that is the root node. What do you mean by height? See, height and depth are two important parameters one has to clearly distinct between the two terminologies. When you say a height, whenever you say a height, you always nod your head upwards. You always nod. Say, for example, in front of you, a very tall building is there. In front of you, very tall tree is there. Or in front of you, very tall person is there. Or in front of you, very tall animal is there. Means suddenly you will nod your head upwards and see, wow, how tall it is, like that you will say. So likewise here, when a tree is given like this, so when you want to calculate the height or when you want to say the height, imagine that you are staying here. So you will look upward, that is from the leaf node to root node, the height is calculated. So leaf node is at level height 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that it goes on. Likewise, when you want to define the depth, so whenever you you have to see a swimming pool or when you are in the highest tower, we want to see how depth it is. Or whenever you stand in a dam, you want to see how depth it is. Or when you are sitting in a tall building, you want to sit in see how depth it is. That means you will always nod your head down. That means in case of tree, you assume that you should be standing here and you are looking down. So depth means A is at depth 0, 1, ABC is at depth 1, depth 3, depth 4, and M is at depth 5, like that. So when you want to say height, so height is from this side. Height is from this side and depth is from top to bottom. Height is from bottom to top and depth is from top to bottom. Next important topic is representation. How to represent the tree? That means, this diagram is a logical diagram, but you cannot store the data. Where is the data here? A is one data, B is one data, C is. In the place of data, you can have a name. If you are creating a data structure for a classroom, in the place of ABC, you can create a place. If you want to create a data structure for tour plan, a tree data structure for a tour plan, or employees, or their designations, or their salaries, like that you can say. So when you say this as a terminologies, so you will always say this one, right? What is that is? Link representation is, see, this is the logical diagram that is for understanding purpose, but you cannot store like this in the computer memory. So computer memory, you have to assume a contiguous memory location, and the data is stored in a sequential manner. So even though the data access is a non-linear, but see, non-linear here refers not the storage, but the access. Access is the because the arrangement is like that. So based on the arrangement only, we can access the data. So what is this is, whenever a tree is given to you, and if you want to do a linear representation is nothing but array representation. When you want to use array representation, so first thing you need to calculate the size of the array. So size of the array here is calculated using a formula 2 to the power L plus 1 minus 1, where L is the maximum level. That is not the maximum number of level, that is maximum level. So for the tree, Z A level is 0, C B level 1 is 1, 2, 3. So therefore 2 to the power 3 plus 1 minus 1. 2 to the power 3 plus 1 minus 1, 2 to the power 4. 2 to the power 4 is 16, 16 minus 1, 15. So totally 15 locations. So in each location, you have the item, you have to place the item. So what is the rule that is followed to place the item is, if you see, to start with, you have to start by placing the root element. So root element should be placed in A. Root element will be placed in the location 1. After placing the root element A in the first location, then you need to check 2n, 2n plus 1. In 2n location, you have to place, see, if A is there, then it's A is there in the first location, then it's C should be in 2n location. That means 2 into 1, second location. And B is in the 2n plus 1, 3, third location. So likewise, B, so now C is there. C, right, M, left M is there. So C is at location 2. So 2 to the power, 2 into N. So that is fourth location, M is there. So likewise, you need to use the formula 2n and 2n plus 1. So by randomly putting or by voluntarily assigning A to the first location, the remaining locations for the remaining data items can be discussed or it can be viewed like this. So that is what linear representation is about. So what is this linked representation? So linked representation, here you have to represent the tree in terms of a pointers. See, every node, it is a logical diagram that you want to see as a node. So if you want to go for linked list, you know that how to link list is a linked list, because in the earlier class, that is under in your undergraduate class level, you have studied about the linked list. So you have a node, and the node has three partition if it is a single linked list. So in the mid part, if it is a double linked list, in the mid part you have a data, and in the right part you have one link, and in the left part you have one other link. So it may be header or maybe. So if there is another node here, then what is this idea is all about is, you have B, and this location give max to here, and this may be a null node. So say for example, so this is doubly linked list. If it is a single list, there is only one link is there. So one side there is three compartment is not required. But here you have two pointers in what this is, the forward pointer, backward pointer in case of linked list. But if the same two pointers is present in the tree, and that pointer is called left pointer, right pointer. So this is just an idea that is this is not exactly the location what I am trying to convey. So if A is one, B is like that, formula is not applicable. You can put whatever the location it is there, and put the null for element where it doesn't have any child. Say D left and right doesn't have any child, so it is both null. So D, look at D has both no left and right pointer, so it is made as null. So likewise, the linked representation is. So the representation of trees, what is the difference? That is, what is the difference? What is the process? So I already told that the linear representation is nothing but array representation. That is, you are using the memory programming concepts. I am talking this array is not an instruction, this is a programming concept. So the programming concept array is there, which is helpful to represent the tree in the computer memory. Otherwise, you can go for pointers. So pointer is the linked representation. So that is what. So linear or sequential array. Within bracket, you can say that it is a static memory allocation. So what is static memory allocation is, when you are going to use an array, you have to predefinedly say what size of array you are in need and how many numbers you are going to insert it. That's way you have to give answer to it, and based on the answer, it will assign the value. So likewise, one way for a linked representation, the linked representation memory allocation is dynamic. You cannot say in period the locations, and whenever you need a node, you just add a node. And what you have to do is just pointer arrangements. You have to make the front pointer, right pointer. So like that, you need to do a simple pointer adjustments. So there are two cases when you want to discuss about the representation. What is the advantages with respect to linear, and what is the disadvantages? Likewise, what is the advantages with respect to linked, and what is the linear disadvantages? When you come with the advantages are simple and easier to find any node, and it is easy to implement. Yes, of course, it's an array, right? It's an array, it is easy. But when you want to go for array, see, when you have studied the first undergraduate classes, what are the difference between a pointer and a linked list? Same pointer is applicable. See, when you arrange a data item, say for example, in a tree array, you have a data item, and if you arrange the data item here, 5, 10, and if you want to insert a 10 in between 5 and 10, say for example, I want to insert a number 8 between 5 and 8, what you can do? So you have to create one memory location and push the element to onward outside upward, and then you are doing this. So research shows that the data movement has a little costlier in terms of CPU cycles, and it consumes more time. So what you can do is, instead of moving the data from the location to, instead of relocating the data items, what you can have any other idea or not. So that idea is worked out, and that idea comes out as a concept called pointers or linked list. Also here, there is a wastage of memory. Say for example, when you are going to delete an element, that is the mid of the two or three elements, then it means the deleted location won't be adjusted, it is keep as such. So there is a wastage of memory also. And when you come to disadvantages of the linked list, you cannot directly access the node. See, in their advantages is directly access. How? By mentioning the location. Say for example, index element, I want to access A of 5. A of 5, if I want to access, if you say like that means, so you want to access the element that is in fifth location within the square bracket you mentioned. So that flexibility is not here. So no direct access to your node, and requires additional space for, and requires, yes, it requires additional space. So for whatever, see here, there is only one location is sufficient, but here you need additional location. How many additional location? Two locations. So when that case is discussed with the wastage of memory, due to null pointers. So whenever, see here, there are so many null pointers. So when you want to create a linked list, so you always compromise with these two disadvantages. So that is the pros and cons of the both the kinds of representation. So there are many D-tree data structures available: binary tree, expression tree, binary search tree, AVL tree, MVSS tree, B tree, splay tree. Some trees are concerned with intensive. In general, the tree data structure, in general, we are studying a structure that is whose focus is on arrangement of data items. So that is the data is arranged. So with the help of that, you need to do that idea. So what is that? You can have the binary tree, expression tree, binary search tree, AVL trees. That is workable for internal memory like ROM and RAM. So you know that what is internal memory, right? So ROM and RAM. So but for larger memory like a computer disk or some file structures or some clouds like that, so those things are not that much beneficial. So you can go for MDS-HTP tree split tree. Among those, the topic of the syllabus is binary tree and B tree. Anyhow, I will touch upon the few other trees in order to make you to understand the concept. Another one more tree is red black tree. Here it is not given, but I will cover that topic after covering the binary search tree. I will cover the topic, or after covering the B tree, I will cover the topic. Right. So when you discuss about the specialization, there are enormous specializations, nothing but types. There are enormous types of data structure, but all these data structure are not workable for the same way. Few can be workable for internal, few can be workable for external. What are the various operations on the tree? So there you can do a lot of operations. The major operation is a traversal, you know that very well. So with the in order to see, there are problems will be coming in this aspect also. So they will be giving a tree and they will be asking you to do the in order, post order and pre-order traversal. So tree is given and you are asking to do that in order, pre-order, post order traversal. As well as they will be giving two order of traversal. Remember students, this is the most important questions when it compared with the MCQ. Regarding the traversal of the tree, they will be giving a tree and you are asked to write in order, pre-order, and post order. Otherwise, they will give in order and pre-order, you have to calculate the post order. With respect to searching in the tree data structure, we have many search techniques. So two to search only depth. So in depth wise, if you go search the element, that is depth wise. If it is in the longitudinal size, then it is a breadth wise. So likewise, so the original purpose of tree data structure is to search for the element. Is to search for the element as well as to traverse the element. Traverse the element. So if that fails, then the tree data structure get entirely collapsed. So binary tree, in general, tree is a data structure which has no restriction on number of bytes. You can increase any number of bytes and go to the thing and you can do some kind of sort of stuff. So each node has at most two children. So you have a special case. So what is a full binary tree and a complete binary tree? See, this is a full binary tree. What is this full binary tree? All the levels are completely filled with the nodes. All the levels are completely filled with the nodes. And each node is assigned with some data values. Then it is complete full binary tree. Full binary tree. What is complete binary tree? It is filled with all the levels, but there are some empty partial. Okay, see here it is no node. And here one left side is missing. Here one right side is missing. So something is missing. Something is missing. So that is the thing that you need to focus. So this is called a full binary tree. So in general, in a binary tree, you have two halves. One is a left subtree, another one is a left. So how long the tree is, how big the tree is, you have to treat the tree in two halves. So one half corresponds to left subtree and another half corresponds to right subtree. So binary tree traversal, inner traversal, pre-order traversal, post-order traversal. So when a tree is, this is also some important type of question. I don't think so they will ask this because in your syllabus it is not given. So directly they went to binary search tree. So anyhow, keep remembering. Sometimes it may be asked, you have to give answer. Otherwise, you can refer your undergraduate notes or book or any YouTube lectures can understand. So what is inner traversal? Inner traversal is root comes first, left comes first, then root, then right. So LDR here, D refers to root. So LDR means root comes first. D means L means left comes first, D means root, R means right. So left, so if you are going to traverse this tree via in order fashion means you are coming to the A, then you are coming to B, then you are coming to C, then you are diverging to H. So here you can see that no more descended elements and it is most child of the given tree. So it is printed. So likewise, next to what is printed, the root, so H is printed. So if you go through it very pleasantly, so you can find the various ideas pertaining how it is working, the binary terms. Likewise, pre-order and likewise, post-order. So you should always keep remember the rule, L or D, D, L, R. So like there are comments, so that you will be clearly understanding the traversal. In case a tree is given to you, also you can able to decode the traversal. Or if two traversal is given, you can ask to find one more traversal. So those things will be find out using this tree. Expression tree. Expression tree is also a binary tree. That means it has two branches and a node. But what is the thing is, the left child is having a the intermediate child. Intermediate child. That means the child between the root and leaves. The intermediate childs are having the operators, having only the operators. And the leaf child will be having the operands. So if a tree contains two branches and its face is like a then it is going to be an expression tree. So that's what the expression tree uses. You see that the expression tree can also be given and you are asked to find out the traversal. Infix expression, postfix expression. The same principle is applied. Only thing in the tree, you can find two branches because it is a binary tree, and you can find the symbols in the beginning and letters in the end. So that is the idea. So you can find in order, pre-order, reverse order, traversal. I think you can remember it and recall it from your undergraduate course. If not, you please recall it at this time so that you will answer the MCQ type question. So what is this weakness of binary tree? See, the binary tree occupies more time. It is not arranged in so that is blah blah. So what you can do is you have to see through the node binary tree very carefully. See, whenever you want to do a search operation, because obviously why we need to go for a binary, why we need to go for a tree is in order to store and represent the data in a hierarchical manner, so that the retrieval is very faster when compared with the array as well as linked list. So only you are going for this thing. But when the tree is very big and it consumes more time during the search of the items, so what you can feel is definitely or you will be restricted to do so. So then it is the case you can avoid this idea of a binary tree, that is two branches, or you can add some other constraint. If you add some other constraint, then the tree will become a binary search tree. That is, it has the same property what the binary tree is concerned, that is root node, child node, leaf node, like that stuff, as well as the the stick where you will be using it. And that is the case which is going for the binary search tree. So binary search tree has a special property. So what is that special property is, it is the property is imposed on the value. So whenever you want to create a tree with respect to the values, you will place the value which is treated as the value higher than the left subtree, and in the right side you will place the value which is lesser than the root subtree. So that is the idea of constructing a binary tree. I hope you understand, because here only our topic starts. So another information that I have given so far is just a refreshing information. So here only our topic starts. So whenever a tree is given and you are asked to store the data item, the tree, so you have to place an element in the root first, maybe in a random manner root first. Then followed by you will have to fill up the left chain. So in the left chain, if you want to take a value and that value is still greater than the root node, then you have to change the root node. And if it found less than, then you have to keep the node in the intermediate level. Next, if you want to see the intermediate, and if that also you can see the same idea, then you have to. So likewise, there is no change in it when compared to the binary tree. So, but in the case of binary search tree, you have the restriction. But this restriction will be very powerful restriction, and it is the one which makes the searching operation very, very effective in a tree. Otherwise, I think you know that in many colleges they are running the. So, weakness of what is the weakness of binary search tree? So, the weakness of binary search tree is. There is a restriction. Say for example, you may not give a guarantee that the data will be of this order that is preferable to you. So the data may be of any order and it may be of any value. So your goal is to construct the a tree. But while constructing the tree, you may find with a kind of situation called skewed. Say for example, if the given elements are 9, 10, 8, 7, like that it goes means. And if you want to create a tree means, that is if the tree is lesser than the 8. Now the key thing is he is not able to charge it. So now the thing is, so when the number 9 is placed at one node randomly, then its left check should be the number it is less than. So if you find that when in this case, when the number is always in the descending order, then the tree is also, yeah, like biased. In one side, it is a skewy. Yeah, inside, it is a slanting. That is called skewed nature. This is the major weakness of binary search tree. Even though binary search tree seems to be powerful than the linear search and it is widely applied, it is a little, it is having the main weaknesses. What are those weaknesses? One particular weakness is this one. That is like to skewed tree, right? Skewed tree. So that is the thing. So how to avoid this weaknesses? You can avoid the weaknesses by means of introducing the height balance factor, and which separates the tree with the left and right by calculating the elements according to the element value. You can change the operations of making the AVL tree always positive and reliable with the thing. So what is the balance factors when you are going to see? When you are going to do the tree, you have to see, we say, for example, in this binary tree, the height of the binary search tree of the left child is, so you have one height, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are only 7, 8 heights, I think so. But when you take the case of AVL tree, this has to be given some rotation operations, and the tree can be modeled or molded according to the one which is good for the thing. So that when you go for the doing such a thing, then your binary search tree will sure to follow certain rule. What is that rule? So the rule is left subtree should be less than the right subtree, and the content will be equally shared by both the tree. So that is the AVL tree. So I am not going to touch the AVL tree today now. So I think I introduced the binary search tree. So maybe in the subsequent classes, we will talk about some more ideas pertaining to our subject, right? So with this, I stop recording the class. Can you hear me, Lakshmi or Preeti? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Are you okay and comfortable with it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Madam?